convict. Up front, yeah. Convict music.
Gross.
Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Angie Blackson, and this is my YouTube channel. So instead of filming like that in-depth I look like I always do, I wanted to, actually a lot of people asked me to film my Radiant Glow favorite foundation routine. I think I'm not gonna include favorite, but my Radiant Glow foundation routine. My foundation routine that lasts all day long and that I do not crack Radiant Glow routine. Had so much fun. If you guys want a certain look for me to film, I would love to film that. Just let me know. Email me, Instagram me, Facebook me. I will do whatever you guys want. And this is a channel for you guys to come and like just love makeup as much as I do. And I've always loved makeup. But makeup is my passion. I love doing different looks. I actually love this eye look. I might film this eye look for like a holiday look because it was so sparkly and green. And I love how it brings out my eyes. My eyes kind of look green But I think for my next video, a lot of people have been mentioning I should do a smoky purple eye. Like, that'll be like a lot of fun. And I think purple eyes, they bring out like a lot of blues and greens and brown eyes. So I might do that for my next one. I have a few ideas that I'm going to do because my mom said, just ask me and I'll suggest. But sometimes her suggestions are kind of basic. Like, she told me to do like a natural foundation routine. I'm not doing that. That's boring. Like, and I don't do natural. I do full coverage. I do a full beat. If you don't like it, don't watch it. Just saying. Anyways, you guys, I hope you guys enjoy this video. Don't forget to subscribe as always. Love you. Until next time.
Hey, you guys, we're here to get started on my favorite radiant glowy foundation routine. So I'm going to do the foundation and then I'm going to do my eyeshadow off camera and I'm going to continue with bronzing, highlight, the whole jazz. Maybe I'll do eyebrows on camera. I'm not sure. Anyways, so we're going to hydrate. We already hydrated the skin. Now we're just going to prime. So obviously, if you want your foundation lasting for a really long time, you need to put a proper base. Like, always use a primer. Basically, like, a primer is the foundation of your actual foundation that's gonna stick on and last all day long. Same with paint. You always put a primer on paint, then you put the actual paint, and you put a gloss. Same thing with makeup. So my favorite a primer that I use on a daily routine to make my skin really radiant and long lasting is this MAC Prep and Prime Natural Radiance. And this is the pink one. They have a yellow one and they have a pink one. And this is my favorite. So it does have a shimmer, but also it's hydrating. It's more like a lotion. I don't know how I'm gonna. Yeah, so it's like a pink lotion and it has some sheen to it. And I love this primer. I used to use it religiously. Like, it was like my favorite. It is like $50-something, but this will last you forever. This is 50 mils. You don't need a lot. I love it for the hydrating purposes and also radiance, aka why it's called natural radiance. They have a yellow one. I used to use the yellow one when I was a lot tanner, but because I have more of a cool tone, undertone, like kind of like a pink because I'm so pale, I use the pink one. Just saying. And now we want to keep that radiant still like onto the face. So usually I'll add the MAC strobe cream. This is just a cream, but it has shimmer in it. And I love this for like other hydrating purposes. And also like anything that you use, like luminous or radiance or any of those words, it's gonna give you like glowy skin. Especially because I'm dry, that will just like outshine over like matte looking skin. With matte skin, it's more on the drier side, but I love using this lotion just for hydrating purposes. Also, it adds like a really beautiful shimmer. One of my coworkers, she uses this like after she applies like her highlighter and stuff, and she just adds it to the cheeks. You could do that too, but I just put this under my foundation. And this is the pink one. They have other ones. They have a silver one, a red one, a peach one, a gold one. They have all different kinds, but this is the original one, which is the pink. So we're just gonna apply this. It smells like kind of like sunscreen. Yeah, so this basically, it's made for instant hydration and radiance. So now that I'm completely hydrated, and I love the packaging too, it's super cute. We're gonna move on to foundation. I'm just gonna spray some setting spray on my face. This is the e.l.f. Dewy Setting Mist. I'm running low, but who cares? Okay, now we're gonna move on to foundation. And you guys know I love this Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation. These are my two favorite foundations to make my skin full coverage. We're gonna go in with another liquid foundation, and I'm not going for thin coverage, I'm going for full coverage. And if I just add this foundation, my skin would be like more of a sheer foundation, which I'm not going for that. Which is why I always add stick foundations in my foundation routine. Okay, we're gonna use the shade Vanilla. This is Vanilla, right? Yeah, this is Vanilla. This is a new one. I'm just gonna paint this all over in the middle of the face because it's a lighter shade. I just thought I would film for you guys like a foundation routine because I've been filming like a lot of different eye makeup looks, and I want to focus like more onto the skin this time because I know a lot of people, you know, they want to know like how I make my skin so flawless looking, and I find like skin is really in right now, like the Korean skincare is really in right now just because yeah, like Korean skin is like beautiful, like all those sheet masks that are incorporated, like that is a huge culture favorite in Korea because their skin is so porcelain looking. That's why. And then we're gonna go in the shade with Nude. And if I blended all of this out, this would have been very sheer coverage, but this is just one part of my step of foundation because I don't like sheer foundation. I like a thick, full coverage because I have a lot of acne. A lot of people say I don't have it, but I do. And then I'm just gonna paint that on. I look kind of crazy, but don't worry. We're gonna blend it out. Trust me, do as I do, don't do as I say. That's the shade Nude. Perfect. As I do, don't do as I say. That's the shade Nude. Perfect. And then we're gonna use, I'm actually gonna use a different foundation besides my Too Faced Born This Way foundation just because this is more of a full coverage foundation. And I wanna show you my complete bougie as fuck foundation I've been using. So this is the Dior Forever Undercover 24 Hour Full Coverage Foundation. This stuff is thick, but I find it's not as full coverage as they say when you just wear this on its own, which is why I always wear the Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation. So this stuff is beautiful, and it gives you a really nice, poreless finish, and it does have a pore refining ingredient in here, so it makes you look like flawless. And this is in the shade 024. It is called Soft Almond. This stuff is expensive, but it lasts you forever. Like, you don't need a lot. And I love the packaging. They had this is actually a new packaging, and they did change their formula a little bit. They made this one last 24 hours. So this is going to keep your foundation on for a really long time, and it's going to last and give you that beautiful skin-like skin that you're looking for. It's going to give you that flawless foundation, a beautiful skin, which is why people think I'm a lot younger than I am, because I'm only 27. And these are the steps I do to give myself a beautiful skin. I'm really into the whole skin look, you know, like I'm lucky I don't have like oily or acneic skin, but I definitely take care of my skin. I do a mask every night. I do a sheet mask. I love, like, my mom always taught me, you gotta wash your face, you gotta take care of your skin, because if you don't have good skin, the makeup's not gonna look good. That's just like how it is. Always moisturize, whatever. Okay, so we're just gonna take the Morphe sponge. This is my favorite sponge. This is, I think, the contour highlight sponge. And we're just gonna take the Dior Forever foundation and just squirt it out like that. I love like the packaging. It's like really accessible. Now I'm just gonna spray the setting spray onto the sponge and pat that out. Just like that. Down to the neck. Okay, that's done. That's looking bomb AF. I actually need another setting spray. You know I come prepared.
This is the one I have right now just because I didn't buy more when the coronavirus came out and now I can't. Everything's fucking closed, which is annoying. But whatever. Who cares? You know? Okay, now we're going to move on to concealer. And because I want this to be a long-lasting foundation routine, I'll use the Tarte Shape Tape. In my last few videos, I actually mentioned that this was a little too thick. But when I want my foundation to last a really long time, I'll use the Tarte Shape Tape because it will not move, honey. I think in the past few videos, I've been loving the Jeffree Star one just because it's not as thick, but it does the job, and the Jouer one. But this is always my go-to when I want a long-lasting finish at the end of the day because it will last a long time and it will not move or go anywhere. So I'm using the shade Light. I'm just gonna apply that to the under eye. And also, like, I have some breakouts. If you guys feel like you have blemishes or anything, use this concealer because it's quite a full coverage and it will cover. Because a lot of my girlfriends say that they can't find a concealer to cover any blemishes. You just need to, like, find the right concealer for you. Like, this one is full coverage. This will cover anything. I promise, which is not the best idea when you have blemishes, but if you're going out and you want to show your blemish, use this concealer. Okay, and then I'm just going to put some on this side here. Like I know it's a lot of concealer, but we're gonna blend it out and I'll show you. It'll look beautiful. My voice is so raspy because I kind of just woke up. Okay. And then we're just gonna blend that out. Just like that. And then after the bottom of the face, and I find it really like stands out when you do the bottom half of the face. And also they teach you this in makeup school. I know a lot of people don't do this, but this is what I do to make my makeup look so flawless and long lasting. Cause you think about it, you put concealer, then you put powder, then you put baking, it's gonna like stand out. Same with the under eye. Okay, now I'm just gonna apply some powder, and I'm gonna use the Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Airbrush Flawless Finish Skin Perfecting Micro Powder in the shade One Fair. This is my favorite powder of all time. It's super pigmented. Now we're gonna stop spraying the sponge and use the clean side. We're just gonna apply that. Like, look how pigmented is it. No wonder it's my favorite. I remember the last one I bought, I broke it. And I was like so sad. I went on Sephora and bought one right away. They never used to sell Charlotte Tilbury at Sephora. They just recently brought it in there. I used to buy it from Beautylish. And the reason why you don't want your sponge wet when you dip your sponge in the powder, because it'll ruin the powder and it'll be hard to use, which is why. Like, look how pigmented that is. And when you apply this onto your skin, it's so soft. Like, I've never used a powder like this, which is why it's one of my favorites. Like, it's just like, oh, bitch. And I did hit pan, so I need a new one soon, but I should be okay for now. They're always sold out of the fair shades too, which is why sometimes I don't buy it because it's always sold out. My favorite powder to set the whole face. Like, it's so pretty. It's more of a translucent powder, but it does have shimmer in it, if you guys can see. So we're gonna take this, the clean side part of the sponge, the flat side. We're just gonna dip and we're just gonna set the entire face with that. Yes, honey. Yes. The reason why I wanted to film this video was because a lot of people was asking me, can you go more in depth in your foundation routine? Yeah, because, like, you know, I do this foundation routine every day of my life, so I know what I'm doing. A lot of people don't do this foundation routine, so they don't know what they're doing, and they just wanted me to go more in depth, like, why I think my makeup lasts for so long and it looks flawless for so long. So I just thought I would film this video for you guys. I have mentioned this powder is similar to the Charlotte Tilbury Under Eye Genius powder, I think it's called. It's a really nice powder. It's a little more on the shimmer side, but it's really nice. I just don't like the smell. It smells like old lady. But I do like the packaging. It's like a good product, but if you guys can get past the smell, then you guys can use that. But I don't like the smell. I like this one. Everyone likes what they like. I'm talking so much. Okay, next we're gonna do another powder. You guys know I love the Jaclyn Cosmetics. This is her Luminous powder. This one's called Brighten Up. So this one I usually apply all over the face. I'm gonna try applying it with the sponge. I usually apply it with a brush, but I just wanna see the results applying with the sponge, just to like pat that in. Because I don't know, I just want to do something different. Because let's be honest, I like to be different. I always tell people, like, I'm definitely not like any other girl out there. Definitely tell my boyfriend that all the time. And he knows, like, I'm definitely different than most girls. I'm very, like, understanding. I'm not, like, I don't want to say I'm not crazy, because I kind of am. And he always says all hot girls are crazy, which I don't think I'm that good looking. I think I'm okay. But he thinks I'm crazy, so, you know. But that's why he loves me, because I'm crazy. Yeah. I definitely have my moments. Like, I mean, I'm a woman like everyone else. I get my period, which is normal. Yeah, now this powder, it definitely has a luminous effect, which is why I want to add it. It just gives you a really nice glow. I have applied this powder with a sponge before, but I think the sponge I bought had tears in it, so I found like there were red marks all over my face. But I think this sponge is definitely more new, so it should work better. Do my eyebrows on camera just because I never do, and I just want to show you guys how I do my eyebrows. So I'm going to go in with the Anastasia Brow Definer. This is in the shade Chocolate, and I basically brush my eyebrow up. Oops, this one's kind of broken, so I gotta be careful how much I like push it up. Okay, so now we brush that eyebrow up. We're just gonna draw a line underneath. Like that. And then we're just gonna brush the hairs down. Like that, and we're just gonna fill it in. Like that, perfect. We're just gonna lightly, as we go like more into the bridge of the nose, we're just gonna lightly draw it. So we don't want it too harsh looking from the start of the eyebrow. Like that. Okay, now we're gonna use the Anastasia Dip Brow, but I just have a sample of it. I don't have the actual jar, but I'm just gonna show you guys. It is a little dried out, and if your pomade is dry out, don't use water or oil because it will actually ruin the product. I usually use setting spray, and I just spray it, and that's gonna activate the product and just add it, makes it more moist. Talking like way too fast, that's why I'm slurring my words. And then I'm just gonna take any brow product. This is a Morphe one I got in the brow kit. I actually don't know the number because it's worn off. It's very loved. Okay, and then I'm just gonna spray a little bit more because it is quite, it's definitely dried out. I find when you apply setting mist, it definitely like makes the product, brings it back to life basically. Okay, now we have the product on the brush. We're just gonna lightly brush it and fill any like gaps that we had that we drew with the brow definer. And then lightly brush it. Like that, perfect. And we're just gonna take that Anastasia Brow Definer spoolie. And we're just gonna brush it out. And that's how I do my eyebrows. I'm gonna do the other eyebrow really quickly. Okay, now that we're done the eyebrows, we're gonna go on with a contour. Contour. So my favorite contour powder of all time is this Dior Backstage Contour Palette. And I love this palette. It's a very loved. I haven't hit pan yet, which is surprising. And I always use this contour powder if I apply the Charlotte Tilbury powder. I just find like they work so well together. Okay, and I'm gonna use my favorite contour brush. This is the Morphe Jaclyn Hill JH05. I like it because it's like stubby and short and it kind of like blends really well. So we're gonna use these two shades. So this is the light contour and the deep contour. This is a little too light and this is a little too dark, so I always like mix. Just because I don't want to like blend forever. It's going to be real. Okay, so we're just going to suck in the cheeks and go like this. Sarah, and I think I'm going to go for a really glowy, kind of bronzy kind of look. So I'm going to just use the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in the shade Give Me Sun. This is one of my favorite bronzer shades just because it's like the perfect bronze. Like it's not too dark, not too light. It has kind of an orangey undertone, which complements a lot of different skin tones. So I'm just going to use, I think I'm going to use this brush. This is the Morphe R2. This is one of my favorite bronzer brushes of all time. I'm just going to apply. This is definitely a known favorite with a lot of YouTubers, makeup artists. They love this bronzer. This is like one to have in your kit, your makeup collection. It's perfect. Okay, we're just going to apply to the cheekbones. A beautiful glow. Yes, bitch. Okay. Now we're just gonna set the bottom half of the face really quickly. And I'm going to go in with the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. You guys know, oh my God, my voice. You guys know I love this translucent setting powder for setting the bottom of the face because it does have a lot of staying powder and it definitely does the job. But you guys know I don't like setting the bottom of my face just because it's so dry under my eyes and my eyes tend to be a lot more dry than the bottom half of my face. Although when I have my skin conditions, like when it's winter, definitely here I get dry skin. That's normal though. Okay, we're just gonna...
Okay, I'm back, you guys. I just did my eyeshadow, my lashes, my eyeliner. Just my eyes off camera. It's actually a really pretty look. Maybe if you guys like this eyeshadow look, maybe I'll do that for my next video, or purple smoky eye. Anyways, I'm bubbly. So we're gonna finish the rest of the complexion. So we're just gonna take any brush and just take that bakage off, just cuz. Retouch. Okay, now because we lost some just color on the bottom half of the face, just to add some depth and definition, I'm just going to take that Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finishing Micro Powder, and we're just going to use the sponge. I'm just going to pat that on the bottom half of the face, just like that. And I love doing this step in my makeup routine because it just adds such a difference. Like, look at that. That's looking like hollow, and this just like makes your skin back to life. I do a makeup look and then I gotta go out later, I'll just like basically use the sponge and the powder just to add life back to your face. It just like, you know, adds life to your makeup again. Yeah, perfect. And because of that line there, I want to go back in with the bronzer. I know this is kind of a high maintenance kind of in-depthness, but this is what I do to make my makeup last all day long, and it just makes such a difference. And we're just gonna go back in with that Give Me Sun bronzer just to add some warmth to the cheekbones again. Just because I used some of that powder earlier just to tap some of it in the forehead, and it kind of like drowned too much paleness on the forehead. Okay, now we're done with that. We're just gonna use a blush. I don't know what kind I wanna use. I'll just use this MAC one. This is the MAC Mineralized Blush in Warm Soul. I love this blush. So it gives you like a really nice, like glowy, I'll like swatch it for you guys. It just has like a light shimmer. It gives you like a really nice glow. It's like a peachy shade. It's really pretty. I'm just gonna use, I don't know what blush brush I'm gonna use. I'll just use this one. This is one of my favorites. This is the Morphe Y4. I'm just gonna dip that into the product. I love these mineralized blushes. It just gives you like a really nice, corally, shimmery blush, which I don't usually like shimmery blushes, but this is a really pretty blush. It's very subtle. And I find like the Mineralize collection from MAC, they do last for a really long time. And I think it'll look really pretty with this eye look, with the green glow. I'm gonna go in with the Jaclyn Cosmetics Luminous Powder in Do Me. We're just gonna put this lightly on the cheeks. And I'm just gonna use the Jaclyn Cosmetics J01 brush. I love this brush for applying this powder. And this powder does have a blurring effect, so it's gonna make your skin look really flawless. So I just like rub that. This is gonna diffuse our blush a little bit, and it's just gonna give you like glow from within. And it's just gonna like, when we put the actual highlight, it's just gonna like beam through and be even more intense.
I always do this step. Always add like a luminous kind of powder before I do my actual highlight. I find that just makes my highlight even beam more, which I love to look beaming. Setting mist from Morphe. You guys know I love this product. So before we put on the actual highlights, I always do this step just because it's gonna make your highlight beam even more. So when your skin is kind of like not wet, but kind of damp, and you add the highlight, it's just gonna show even more on all the spots that you apply the highlight. So we're just gonna spray this, shake it, and a really, really glowy, with really glowy skin with the foundation. I'm gonna use this Jaclyn Cosmetics. This is her highlighter palette. It's called The Flash. It's so dirty, but I love this highlight. This was one of the products when she first launched it. It was sold out. Like, I couldn't find it anywhere. Like, I was waiting. I was like, I have to get it. I have to get it. So this is what this highlight is for. And I'm just going to use her Jaclyn Cosmetics. This is the J02 highlighting brush. I love this brush. So I'm just going to go in. It's kind of hard because the palette doesn't go all the way up, but I don't want to like ruin it. So I'm going to use Gleam, Iced, and Sparks. I usually use Memorize and Iced together if I'm really tan, but I use all these three when I'm pale, like now. Okay, we're just going to apply that to the face. And we're just gonna like lightly apply that to the cheeks. And basically, I'm emphasizing my pimple, but who cares? Just doing it for the purpose of the video. Yeah, like that is glowing. I love this highlight. Lately, I haven't been using this highlight palette just because I want to use different products on camera for you guys, because I think it's good to use different products, not always the same products. Even though majority of the time on my channel, I do use a lot of the same stuff, but you gotta change it up, you know? Okay, now we're gonna use another highlight, because I want to be even more beaming. I'm looking like quite glowy, but I want to be more glowy. What's new? I always got to be extra. So I'm going to use this Jaclyn Cosmetics loose highlighter in the shade Bomb. I have her other shades, which are more darker and more like rose gold. But because I'm pale, I like to use this color Bomb. I'll like swatch it on my wrist for you guys. Like, it's like a gold highlight. It's really pretty. And then I'm going to use this Jaclyn Cosmetics J03 brush. This brush is made for her highlight. It's just like a really light brush to apply the highlight generously. So we're just going to tap. Okay, and I'm just going to take a mirror and just apply very generously and gently. Oh my god. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Okay. To the other side of the face. You guys, if you watch my channel, you know I love to look highlighted and glowy. We're gonna go in with the Jaclyn Cosmetics loose highlighter in the shade Extra. I always like apply a gold highlight and then a white highlight to make it really beam through, because when it hits the light, it's gonna be beaming. That's the trick I learned. If you wanna be extra glowy, always add like a gold or a darker kind of bronzy highlight like this one, and then add a lighter one. I'll swatch this one for you. It's like, see, like it just hits the light like that. And I did use this highlight to highlight my inner corner as well. Just add some extraness. Okay, we're just gonna take the clean side of the brush, because we did use the other side, tap it off, and we're just gonna apply really lightly. Don't apply too much because this product is quite pigmented. Like, ooh, yeah. Like, ooh, I just wish that pimple wasn't there. And then just apply Peachy Shade. It's really pretty. just because I don't have another lip liner in front of me. I'm gonna be real. So, okay. I just sharpen it and just take. Okay. I'm just gonna apply that to the lips. It's a really pretty color. It's like so nude. You know what I mean? Okay, we're gonna use, I'm just gonna use this liquid lipstick from Smashbox. So this is Always On Liquid Lipstick in the shade Gotta Light. I use Fair Game in my Champagne Glitter Smoky Eye YouTube tutorial, but I wanna use this one. I didn't mention to this one, mentioned to you guys, I love this one. It's just a little bit darker, which is okay. It smells good. It smells like chocolate. I'm getting hungry. The reason why it's so moussey is because they want it to be like more of a light feel, not like as a heavy matte lip. It's really pretty though, but I don't mind the formula. I like the formula, but I do have to say the Fair Game one dries up a little bit quicker, but that's not something that you need to complain about. Like, makeup is what happens. Okay, for lip gloss, because I love that color. For lip gloss, it is quite dry. I'm just gonna use the Dior Addict Lip Maximizer in 001 Pink, because I love this one, because it'll make my lips super, super glossy. I don't care. It's such a pretty liquid lip. And then we're just going to spray some more of the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist all over it. Just give the seal of the deal. My eyebrow hairs up just because
I'm just trying to fix my hair, you guys. I'm just having, I don't know where to put my part. Anyways, you guys, that is my Radiant Glow foundation routine. I hope that you guys love this video, because I added a lot of tips and tricks for you guys. A lot of my subscribers and viewers wanted to see what's my favorite routine for my foundation for lasting all day long, and that was it. Like, so basically I use a lot of products that last for a long time, like the Dior Forever foundation. It's 24 hours. I definitely have to say the better the product, like the more expensive the product, like Dior obviously is expensive, but I find that they last a long time. And so was the Hourglass Stick foundation. That's always been one of my favorite. I always use on a daily routine. I find like with stick foundation, they are thicker, and when you add it with a liquid, it lasts all day long. Also using the Tarte Shape Tape concealer, it is a thicker concealer, so it does last all day long as well. Also, they have like really good ingredients. Like, I think they have jojoba oil and mango seed oil, so they have a lot of natural ingredients, which if you guys find like thicker concealers are bad for you, Tarte has always been like a very natural kind of line. They use, I think their bronzer is made from Amazonian clay, which is a more natural line. So when I started getting into makeup, I went to Sephora and I wanted to use like good products, and the girl there told me that if you want a more natural line, Tarte is the way to go. They use a lot of like natural ingredients, like the clay, Amazonian clay, mango seed oil, all those different things. So if you guys want a more natural line and think like it's bad for your skin, Tarte has been known for using organic natural ingredients if you're like into that. And Tarte, like everything that I've used from them is
good as well. And as for the glowing skin, for the glow to be beaming and lasting all day, the Jaclyn Cosmetics, of course, it's always one of my favorite lines. I use it in almost every YouTube tutorial. Like, it's just amazing. Like, it just makes your skin last and look so beautiful. Like, look at my glow. Ignore that pimple. But my glow is a beaming, especially since I'm not going anywhere. Yeah, and also the Anastasia brow pencil. I actually showed you guys how I do my brows, which I never really do. So I find, like, I don't know, everyone does their eyebrows totally differently. You don't need to follow my routine specifically, but I do use like a pomade and a pencil just to, because I find the pencil, it doesn't fill them in completely. So I'll go back in with a pencil, eyebrow pencil brush, and then fill it in with a dip brow or any pomade. I also love the Morphe brow pomade. It's a great dupe for the Anastasia if you guys can't afford it. I think this one's like $6 or $7 and the Anastasia one's like 20 something. So yeah, you can find like different kinds of products. You guys obviously don't have to use my products, but a lot of you wanted to know what's my favorite radiant glow foundation for lasting a long time, and there you have it. I find when I do this routine, it lasts all day long, especially like if I have an event to go to. I find like I'm partying, drinking, doing whatever. It'll last for a long time, way longer than any drugstore product that I use. You just have to like decide what you want to do. Like if you want a product to last long, obviously the more bougie the brand is, like this Dior contour palette, it is expensive, but it lasts you a long time and it lasts all day long. That's what I just find with price points of different products. Morphe is obviously affordable. It does have the stamp of the test of time, but I just find like expensive products, they last and do you justice. Like you're paying for the price, obviously. So you just gotta experiment what works for you. This is what works for me. If I want my makeup to last all day long, I do have to say this foundation is expensive. I think it's like $75, but this will last you for like, this is my second bottle that I bought. The first one I bought, it did last over a year, so you don't need a lot. It's quite pigmented. It does cover. It lasts all day long. And like, look at the finish of my face. Like, I have flawless skin, except this pimple, but those are just things you have to do in your daily routine. And I just thought I would focus more on the foundation and not so much the eyeshadow. But if you guys do like this eye look, I can film that for you for a different time. Maybe I'll do it for like a holiday, kind of Christmas, because this kind of looks like holiday-like, and I put some sparkles on there. It's really pretty. I actually used the Anastasia Subculture palette with this look because I wanted it more like an olive green look instead of like powerful green. I was gonna use the Morphe Jeffree Star palettes, but the greens in here, they're not as olive. They're more like bright green, which I'm not about the bright green. I'm more like an olive green kind of girl or forest green kind of girl. But if you guys want to go for that look, you can. I think this eye look, I find greens and purples bring out my eyes really nicely, and reds, of course. But anyways, you guys, I gotta go. I gotta go grocery shopping again. I want to make like, I forgot to buy instant coffee the other day. I went to the grocery store. I was like, what's wrong with me? I was going to do that TikTok whipped coffee thing, but I'm going to go today. Hopefully I'll remember. I never like write a list of grocery stuff. I just remember as I go, because like that's like so time consuming. Anyways, you guys, please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I love filming for you guys as always. I have a lot of fun filming. I look forward, like, because I'm not working right now. I like wake up, I'm like, what kind of look should I do now? I love doing my hair for you guys. I love looking good. Honestly, like when I put makeup and do my hair and put perfume and put earrings, I feel like in a really great mood. So I already did my workout this morning. So I was like, I'm gonna film like my favorite foundation routine, and I'm gonna have fun with it. And I love like filming for you guys. I've been uploading a video almost every day, which I'm really proud of myself. So usually I work 6 days a week. I don't have time to film all the time because I got to get ready and go to work. So I usually do it on my day off and then film throughout the week. But now I have all the time in the freaking world to film for you guys. Anyways, you guys, don't forget to subscribe. I'm babbling again. Just had coffee and I'm like super hyper. But anything you guys want me to do, I will love to do. Any suggestions, just give me some ideas. One of my subscribers wanted me to do like a purple smoky eye. I might do that for my next video because I think like purples are really like hard for some people. And like they're not that hard to do. And I actually love filming purple smoky eyes, which I've never done one on my channel, but I love doing them. So, and I find they bring out a lot of different eye colors, which is great to compliment. Anyways, you guys, I hope you guys enjoy. I, of course, love filming makeup as always. Have a fantastic day and be safe. Bye. Convict.
Up front, yeah. Convict music.
Ross.
Oh.
Triple C's.
If you ever cross that line, I guarantee you there'll be nothing to save ya. I got a whole bunch of gorillas ready to pull the trigger, and we out for that paper. Coming from a life of crime. Trying to be on my best behavior. You see my raps getting bigger, but still that same nigga busting shots at them haters.
Hold up.
But only if you cross that line.
I was birthed in the crack house, but what made it worse? Every first, it's a pack ties. Little brother knowing life illegal. No toys, just playing with pipes and needles. I'm pouring fire Nikes and Regals. 5,000 on the paint just so life would see ya. Green cards for the free lunch. Now it's green cards, green large and the seats crush. Big guns for the other side. Nigga try me, I'ma teach his mama homicide. I wanna see his mama eyes. I done cried 20 years, now I'm running dry.
I guarantee you there be nothing to save ya. I got a whole bunch of gorillas ready.
Baby,
if you ever cross that line, I guarantee you there'll be nothing to save ya. I got a